Getting your state driver's license. I'm in Connecticut and I have to get my state driver's license in a month, so wish me luck. I have had not much help. I'm doing most of it, basically all of it, on my own, and I would have liked some help, and I would have liked a video like this to kind of help me with every step of the way. So that's what I'm gonna do for you guys. Step one, book your learner's permit test, which you can do online. Just search up DMV, your area, go on the site and book. I mean, your application to book your test is not that difficult. You'll just look on the calendar, choose a date, choose a time, put in your details. You'll need your social security number on hand with you for that. So that's pretty straightforward. That's the first thing you have to do. And right now I'm getting together all the documents I need to take to the DMV tomorrow for my test, for the learner's test. And I'm gonna read it all to you guys now. So once you've booked your test, you'll get a confirmation email that you have to print. So print that out, you'll get it, you'll get all of it. It'll be about 3 pages, and then you have to fill out the information on these pages. Quick side note, you know how we've all got like these, like a little folder? I keep absolutely every single document I get in this folder, and it's been a lifesaver, because I'll always know that like anything I ever need, just get this. And just take this whenever you need to do anything like legal. Just take this folder with you. Even if you sit in front of the people at the desk and you show them all the forms and say, please tell me which one I need. That will work, because at least you have it. At least you have it. This is your first page. This is your third page of your confirmation email document that you've printed. You'll see on the first page it has number one, identity. On the third page it has A2, identity documents. Then it has listed every single document you could possibly bring. So for au pairs, you'd probably say foreign passport and a social security card. Number two, social security number. Every au pair I know should say social security card. Mark that. Connecticut residency, that'll be C on page 3. postmarked mail, that will work. Or a bank statement. I think those are the two easiest things that you can do. Number 4, legal presence in the United States. Or pairs, since you hold a J1 visa, you should put DS-2019 and the I-94. So those are all the things you have to bring when you're doing your learner's permit test. I just passed my learner's test. It wasn't too bad. It was quite it was pretty easy. It's the same as in South Africa, where I went in South Africa. You have laptops, you go, you do your eye test, which is really easy. All I had to do was like look into that eye thing and then read out the letters that I saw, and then they were like, where can you see the light? And there was lights on like each side to your peripheral vision. And yeah, then you just go in, you do your test, you do it in your own time. So if it's you know, whenever you finish, you can leave. You have to get 20 questions right out of 25. And they're all multiple choice. You have like 3 choices and you choose which one is the right answer. So yeah, this is the app that I use to study for the permit test. It's just called DMV. You can download it on the app store, click on DMV test, and it'll have a whole bunch of mock tests that are almost identical to what
the actual thing is.
So now that I've passed my learners, I just called a driving school and asked them if I can book for a 8-hour educational class, which I can do online. So I'm very happy. Some places don't offer that. So I really hope that you guys are in a place where they offer an online one. But it's compulsory. You have to do it, unfortunately. For me, it cost $125. If I had done it somewhere else, it would have cost me $150. So I saved $25. Girl math. Yeah, the next step is to just do that 8-hour class and get the certificate or whatever you get from that. And then I'm currently waiting to hear back from a driving school to see if they'll do my road test with me. So that I'll do in the next video, because that'll be in a while from now, when I know some of you are like wanting this video to come out soon. As I can imagine, a lot of people end their au pair year around about this festive season. So this video is part one. Part two will come out once I've done the class and I'll give a review on it, and once I've booked my road test and done like a lesson or two before the road test, and I'll do a review of the road test. So that all is pretty self-explanatory. I feel like the beginning phase is the most intimidating, but I've shown you guys what to do. I really hope that it helped, and yeah, just stay tuned for the next videos if you'll still even need it. Love you.